This next fight's one of my picks for fight of the night. This one's Brett Johns versus Montel Jackson at 135 pounds. This is going to be a super exciting fight. Brett Johns, he's 16-2. He's from Wales. He's 28 years old. He's 5'7" tall, and he's 4-2 in the UFC.
Okay. And those two losses are to
Pedro Munhoz and Aljamain Sterling. So those are really good losses. I mean, it's hard to say good losses, but good people to lose to.
The competition, yeah.
The competition level's up there.
And their decisions.
Yeah,
Aljamain Sterling finishes people, and so does Munhoz. So.
Yeah. So then Montel Jackson, he's an American guy, 9-1. He was 8-1 as an amateur. He's 28 years old. He's 4'10" tall. He's 4-1 in the UFC, including his win on Dana White's Contender Series.
Yeah.
Tell me what you think about these guys.
Well, Brett Johns, he doesn't really possess a lot of power. And if you look at his record, he only has 2 wins by knockout out of 16 wins. So you can see he's not
super
powerful.
8 decisions.
8 decisions, yeah.
So.
But he has really solid grappling.
Yeah.
I'd say he's pretty well-rounded in terms of, like, his overall skill level. He's probably comfortable everywhere. He's just not great anywhere. But he's good enough to, you know, compete with the top-level competition. His fight with Aljamain Sterling was really fun.
Yeah. Sterling, that's a top guy. That's a top-five guy right there.
And Sterling was able to get him down a couple times, but he was able to get Sterling down. They did some reversals, and eventually Sterling kind of took control. But, you know, he showed me there that he's got enough to hang with the top-level guys.
Yes.
With Jackson, he's got some power, and he's a bigger...
He's got really good power.
He's a bigger dude for the division.
And he picks good shots.
And an interesting stat, if you watch the Ricky Simone fight, Montel Jackson versus Ricky Simone, which is Jackson's only loss.
Yep.
I think it was Joe Rogan or John... One of those two said that... Jackson has bigger hands than Francis Ngannou.
Really?
Bigger hands than Francis Ngannou.
That's interesting.
Because I was watching that fight, and in the Ricky Simone fight, Jackson was able to wrap his hand all the way around Ricky's hand and just control him from doing anything.
Nice.
It was crazy. Even on the ground, when Ricky had his back and was on top trying to get a submission, he couldn't do anything because Jackson just grabbed his arm. Oops, we're leaning out. Jackson just would grab his arm and just hold it, and Ricky could do nothing.
Yeah.
But, I mean, Ricky out-wrestled him. He just
couldn't finish
because Jackson was able to get a hold of him.
For me, this is what kind of turned me off with Montel Jackson here. So I was doing the research for him, and I'm looking up information. I run across his Wikipedia page, and on his Wikipedia page, they talk about how he was planning on going to wrestle for the Olympics. Yeah, so they're talking like his high school goal was to go wrestle for the Olympic team, but then the Olympics got cut from the Olympics, so he changed careers, or he decided to change careers. You know, he's not that good of a wrestler. He was never going to the Olympics. I went back, I looked at some of his high school wrestling stuff, his Greco matches. He's got a couple of little things that he does. Same things that you see him do with these trips right here where he ties up the body lock and he steps behind the leg and he whips him down. It's the same technique that he used then.
Yeah.
That's the same technique he uses now in the UFC. He wasn't that good of a wrestler. They try to promote it like he's a better wrestler than he was. So that kind of turned me off on that. Like, you look at Ricky Simone, he's a good wrestler.
He showed it in that fight, too.
Showed it in that fight, but even then, you know, Ricky's not at the elite when it comes to the wrestlers in the UFC.
No.
So, while Ricky's great, there's still levels. There's still levels. So that kind of turned me off on him. What it says is that his friend convinced him to come coach some wrestling drills at MMA, or at an MMA gym, and so he did that, and that turned to him competing in jiu-jitsu tournaments, to him fighting in the UFC. That right there was what kind of turned me off on him, was that whole story. But if you look at it, he does have 5 knockouts.
Yeah.
He's got 3 decisions, and he has a win by submission, too, with a Darce choke over Brian Kelleher, and he dropped him with a sweet elbow right before that. That elbow put him down. He went down. I think he hit him with the left elbow, if I remember right. Hit him with the elbow, dropped him, locked up that Darce, finished the fight. That was pretty nice. So then now I'm going to go back and talk a little bit more about Brett Johns. Brett Johns, he's a black belt in jiu-jitsu. He's a black belt in judo. And he's a brown belt in Muay Thai. He's competed in Titan FC, and he's competed in Cage Warriors as well. He's the former Cage Warriors bantamweight champion. So he's been a champion before. He's fought in 5-round fights. But in his next fight where he went to defend it, even though he won that fight, he was stripped of the title because he missed weight. That could potentially play into effect if he's having weight issues, but it's been a long time since then, so I don't think it will be a problem. He also won Performance of the Night against Joe Soto when he beat him with that wicked calf slicer. Then he won a Fight of the Night in a submission win over Tony Gravely. Or in his I think that was a decision win, wasn't it?
I don't remember, it might have been a submission, but I'll
double check it.
Yeah. Either way, you know, I think that Brett Johns is a little bit better than Jackson just about everywhere, except for maybe the stand-up, where I think that's going to be Jackson's best bet.
I think that definitely is.
But I don't think that Brett Johns is going to be able to finish Jackson. It's really, really hard to do. Especially if it goes to the ground, good luck submitting him, because he, unless he's rocked or something, because like he'll do the same thing. He's just gonna grab your arm and hold on until he is stood up.
Yep.
So, I think Brett Johns is gonna win this one by decision.
Yeah, I have Brett Johns winning by decision as well.
All right.
I just think he's a little bit too much on the ground. I think Montel Jackson gets taken down a little bit, and Brett Johns is gonna close that distance. If Brett Johns tries to stand with him, he's getting put out.
He'll get picked apart. I think you're gonna see some leg kicks. You're gonna see some really strong jabs from Jackson, because he's probably got a little bit of reach on him.
Yep.
But other than that, I think Brett Johns is gonna get this to the ground and just grind him for three rounds.
I think so. That's kind of what I'm predicting too.